Hello and welcome to this demonstration of my room booking calendar. This is built using Google Sheets and JavaScript, and I will leave a link in the description so you can get a copy of a blank template. This was created initially for a small NGO working overseas to help them manage where their volunteers were staying and when. So essentially it is a room booking system. It has three sheets. It has the rooms sheet. This is where you can add and edit the rooms that are available. You have the manage bookings sheet. This is where you can book an individual into a room. And you have a calendar view. And this is just a place to see all of the room bookings in one easy view. So let's start with the rooms sheet. On the left-hand side here, we have this blue list. This is all of the available rooms that they currently have. It's grouped by accommodation, and then you have a row for every room in that accommodation. So for example, in the central flat, we have three different rooms. On the right-hand side, we have three editable fields. The first one is an inactive tick box. So if a room is not available for an indefinite amount of time, you can tick that box, and that will mark it as inactive until you untick it. I will show you how that appears in the calendar and manage booking sheets later. Next, you have the rate. This could be a nightly rate. In this case, I've kept it quite open because some accommodation had a nightly rate, some would be a monthly or weekly rate. In this case, it's a double room, so they had two different prices for whether it was an individual or a couple staying in there. Also, we have notes. This allows you to have extra information about the room. Now, the room description should be kept short and simple, but it should be somewhat descriptive. However, we have the notes to add extra information about that room. Now, if you want to add a new room, we would use this small form on the top left. If you're adding it to a brand new accommodation, you can just type it in freehand. Like so. However, if you wanted to add a room to an existing accommodation, you can use the drop down and select it from there, or simply start typing it and it will help you find it quicker. Once you've got the accommodation, you just need to put in a room description. So let's say single three and click add room. That's now added a new row to the sheet, and the focus has appeared in this column under rate, so we can start entering that information. So we now have central flat, single three, and we can enter the details here. Just a note, the reason it says PEN is because that's the local currency of where this organisation worked. It could easily be £22. Great, so that will now appear in the calendar and in the manage bookings sheets as well. There is a rename function here, so maybe that wasn't actually a single room and we want to rename it to double. So what you need to do is enter it in at the top here as you would normally, select the room you want to rename by clicking on that row and click rename. You'll get a confirmation of the changes you're making and you can say okay. And what will happen is that room will simply be renamed. So there we go, it's now called double three. It's moved to the top because it's in alphabetical order. The reason I put in a rename function instead of just deleting and adding it again is because any bookings attached to that room will also be deleted if you delete the room. So this way, everyone who has booked in against the original room name will still be booked in against the new name. However, if we did want to delete it, you click the room, the row of the room in the blue list, and you click delete room. You'll then get a pop-up asking you if this is the room you wanted to delete, and a warning telling you that you will in fact delete all associated bookings as well. To confirm the delete, you type in DEL and click OK. So it's very hard to accidentally delete the wrong room and all of the associated bookings. Great, so that's the room sheet. Let's look at the manage bookings. So in here, you would select the room that you wish to book someone into. So first, let's select the accommodation. Let's go central flat. Secondly, you then get given the list of room descriptions. Now you'll notice here that we've got the double room, but it says inactive beforehand. So if you remember, we marked the double room in here as inactive. So that tick box means that we see it as inactive in this dropdown. So that's a visual cue for the person making the booking. Next, you need to put in the check-in and check-out dates and the booking description. So let's say we're booking this for Spreadsheets Pete. And the date range they are coming to stay is the 25th of May 2019, and they're leaving on the 5th of July 2019. What that does is it will now tell us that's 41 nights that they're staying. We have the rate and the notes pulled through directly from here. So we have that information readily available on the booking form, and we can click book. However, it says the room is unavailable, and that is because the dates we've entered overlap with an existing booking. Now, we could have easily seen that before because of this big red unavailable in the top right here. So let's try a different date. Let's say it's from the 31st. This time, the top right is updated. It says available. It's now in green, so we know it's available. You can also see the other bookings down here in this list. So if I click book, it will now add it to that list. But first, it will warn us that this room is inactive. So you can book against inactive rooms, but the user gets a warning before confirming the booking. So let's go ahead with it. If the room wasn't inactive, it would have gone straight to this point and just said booking added, these are the dates, this is the description, and you can go OK. And you will see it will get added to this list here. The booking appears in chronological order. Now, if you wanted to edit a booking, you would actually have to delete it and add it again. So to delete a booking, you click on the row and click delete selected. So let's say I needed to adjust this booking to be the 1st of June. Maybe I entered in slightly wrong. What I would do is I would just enter it in above as if I was adding it as a new booking. I then click on the existing booking, click delete selected. You will get that similar prompt to check you are deleting the same, the correct booking. I click OK. That's now deleted that from the row. I can now click book again and it will allow me to book it back in with the warning before because it's inactive. There we go. So essentially you can't edit a booking, but you can delete it and add it again. The other thing you have here is delete historic. So this is set up to delete anyone that has checked out over 30 days ago. This is done for two reasons. The first one is to keep the spreadsheet reasonably fast. If there were too many bookings, it would have too much information in there and it would start to slow down. The second reason is we shouldn't be holding data longer than we need to, and we have information like their first and second name. So let's click delete historic. And it will ask us to confirm. It warns you that this will delete all room bookings that have checked out at least 30 days ago. And that means across all rooms, not just the one we have selected, but every room we have in the system. We enter Dell as before and click OK. Historic bookings deleted. And you can see that that first one has now disappeared because it was more than 30 days old. Great, so that's just a way to keep the system running smoothly. Finally, let's have a look at the calendar view. As I said before, this is a place to see all bookings in one place. On the left-hand side, we have the list of the rooms. On the right-hand side, we have the dates and the bookings themselves. The bookings are in blue, What you see here is the booking description. In red, you see checkout dates, and in green, you can see check-in dates. So it's nice and easy to find those important dates. We have this form on the top left, and this allows us to do a few things. First of all, we have a view from date. This is a finite list here. And rather than having to recreate a spreadsheet for every year or for every month, what I've done is set it up so you can say what is the first date that appears. So I can change that to the 8th of April. And you will see this first column has now changed to the 8th of April. And the calendar follows on after that date. This next option is view type. So we're currently in daily. What this means is each column is one day. I have put in 32 days, and that is to cover at least 2 months. However, that's not a huge date range, so you can also change it to weekly. And what will happen now is that you see just 1 week per column. Now, this allows you to see a lot more at once. As you can see, it goes all the way to June 2020, even though we're starting in April 2019. However, it does take away some of the detail. So for example, here, we can't see the checkout date. That's because it's happened, it checks out after the 27th of May and before the 3rd of June. So you don't get the green and red check-in, check-out dates unless it falls on that exact day. But it's a nice way to see the bigger picture. Let's go back to daily. Just a note, the grey columns are indicating dates that have passed. So I'm filming this on the 11th of April, and that is why the 10th, 9th and 8th of April are all greyed out. The next two fields, available from and available to, allows you to enter in a date range that you are looking for rooms availability for. So let's put in an example. Let's say we're doing the 20th of April to the 5th of May. And what that does is it updates the calendar and shows you these highlighted columns. So it shows you the date range that you are currently searching for. So it's a nice visual way to see where it appears against other bookings. Now imagine you had a much larger booking. Maybe they were staying until October. If that was the case, you scroll to the right and it's highlighted all the way. This is where you might want to use the weekly view. I can pop that in, and now I can see, okay, this is where it starts here, and this is where it ends here. So it gives me a good idea of what rooms are available. I can scroll up and down and see that availability. Pop it back to daily for now. Another thing you can do is click this tick box here. So if I tick only available, what it does is it filters out the rooms that are not available for the date range we've entered here in the available from and available to. So this straight away tells us that all of these rooms are available for booking in that date range. I can scroll along and I can see, oh look, this one is pretty convenient because this person checks out just a couple of days before, so we have time to do cleaning of that room and then book that new person in. Great, let me clear that. The final field is show inactive. So remember, we marked this room here as double, this double room as inactive. Well, in here is currently not shown, and that's because we haven't included inactive rooms, because in theory, we shouldn't be booking into them. However, you can show them if you want to. So if you tick the show inactive box, that room now appears in the calendar like any other, but it's shown in red. And you can see further down, there's another one shown in red. So these two rooms are inactive. That concludes the demonstration. I have put a link in the description where you can get a blank copy of this spreadsheet for you to use as you wish. If you have any questions, pop them in the comments or you can email me. Thanks for watching.